Welcome to my video. Ooh. I'm Borley Borlstein. Today I'm gonna be talking about Monos. Mono, not Manos, Hands of Fate. This is Monos, 2019 film. I hope. I saw it yesterday, so I hope that's the case. It's a Colombian film, starring Mozarius. I forget how to pronounce his name. He was a character on Hannah Montana, if any of you are old enough to remember that. And the film is, I've seen it compared to, what's that? The Lord of the Flies, yeah. Lord of the Flies. And other, you know, Descent into Madness, Lost in the Jungle kind of movies or whatever. And in the same vein, the Joker gets compared to Taxi Driver. I think drawing comparisons is a very superficial way to interpret art, unless you're trying to examine which one is more impactful or meaningful in society. Unless you have, you know, an objective in your assessment, there can be no assessment. If you are merely comparing them, I think that's a superficial assessment and, frankly, completely meaningless. I read a review online that at one point in the film, this film, there's a pig's head in the film, and that's a reference to Lord of the Flies because the pig plays so prominently in that film. Maybe, but I doubt it. I just bring it up as an example from some, frankly, very biased review. And I want to talk a little bit about the kind of bias that leads people into making these kinds of stupid assessments. What I've read in the last few days kind of confirms the idea that I have, is that for stupid people, they have 100% correlation between what they like and what is good, and what they don't like and what is bad. If you are a stupid person, you will believe that everything that you like is naturally good, and that everything that you don't like is also bad. Now, I'm not an idiot. I can recognize when something is good, but I don't like it, and I recognize something is bad, but I do like it. That's just a part of maturity, being able to be okay with the things that you like being kind of crude, or, you know, maybe the sound isn't mixed well in a song. You know, it sounds a little jumbled, but there's certain parts of it that really speak to you. Being able to identify where something might be lacking, but still appreciating it on a personal level, that's A-okay. I just want to talk about that a little bit before I get into this film, because I think it's a good film, but it's not a good film for me. And I can see that in a lot of the reviews criticizing the film. And I think, frankly, I didn't get the fucking film either. I guess I should give a brief synopsis. I'm going to go into spoilers because there's no other way to talk about this film. The spoilers don't even matter. There is no story to the film. Don't fucking worry about it. So we start off and we have like 8 to 9 relatively, you know, under 20 is what they're supposed to be passed off as, kids in some mountains in South America, I believe Colombia, and they are in some kind of military operation or outfit, you know, and they engage in kind of some weird Marco Polo thing to kick a soccer ball around because they're bored. And then there's a, you know, a Western white woman that they have with them, and eventually you understand that she's, you know, a hostage that they're using to, like, you know, do some kind of extortion or whatever. And everything is all fine and dandy until the commander guy shows up, and then the commander guy kind of, like, you know, re-regiments them. And in the beginning of the film, you see them all adhering to this kind of military lifestyle, but through the way a child would. You know, they kind of giggle a little bit, but they are, for the most part, as we can tell, soldiers. They have weapons, and they are more regimented than, you know, some of the ISIS fighters. If you've ever seen their training videos, they're rather ridiculous. So, an example of the kind of regiment that they have in the beginning is one of the girls is like, oh, so and so has a question for you. And that person steps up and he's like, I want to be in a relationship with this person. And then they end up in a relationship. So at the beginning of the movie, they're asking permission to date, basically, these kids. By the end of the movie, I think at least half the people have banged each other or something. I don't know. Some of them might have been drug visions. They take mushrooms at one point. It's hard to tell. But the story is rather silly. There's no descent. You see the regimentation of these children. You see them have, fun times as the best they can, being a part of this kind of autonomous bunker in the mountains. And then they are moved into the jungle, and there is nothing connecting we are on our own to putting on war paint, shooting down a helicopter, shooting people on a road from the bushes. There's like a brief montage in the middle part of the film where they're just like literally animals in the woods hunting other humans, essentially. But you don't ever see any other humans except for like one part, and it's perplexing. You don't even see that fall into madness. They're just like stressed out about something that happened earlier, and then the music changes, the cinematography style changes, and they're like fucking full-on painted warriors in the woods doing some crazy shit. Now, it is some cool fucking visuals. And it is some cool fucking, like, I can't call it music. This does not have, really, the movie does not have music in it. It's cool sound design, I think. If you see the trailer, that last little, like, 20 seconds where it's doing this, like, kind of, like, backwards noise, that part is fucking awesome. The problem is that there is nothing that ever matches the audio in the movie visually. Like, there's nothing horrifying. I was never, for a movie about such horrifying concepts of child soldiers, children soldiers who are comfortable doing this, we never see anything that's truly horrifying. We never really see them do anything that really shocks you. It's an incredibly tame movie for something that has such a strong, terrifying theme, the child soldiers. But they don't fucking do anything with it is the part of the movie. But that's part of the story. The story sucks. The cinematography is good at times, and other times it's the camera they had was really shit. There's a one really bad scene where it does like a 200 degree turn, like it's almost like a 180, and every second the camera's moving, everything is blurred and awful looking. It looks like shit. And then the camera finally stops, and then oh, everything looks good. So I don't know what the fuck they were thinking. They should have just cut the shot. They should have just cut the whole fucking turn and just ended on the one lady, because my God, that looked fucking garbage. So when the camera's still, the movie looks beautiful. When the camera's moving, it looks like shit. And that's part of the problem, is that the best parts of the movie are the parts that have no fucking context. The whole body paint scene where they're in the jungle and like a lot of the characters are in blue paint that looks like they have like that silver anemia, whatever blood crazy thing. If you ever read about that, where your whole skin turns blue, and then the two of the girl characters are like in brown and they're all like uniformly walking through the jungle and it looks so fucking cool, and like you see them and they're like super trained soldiers this time around, but like there's no fucking context of what's going on. Like you see them, they're by a road, Then there's a car. Then the car's left burning. They pull over some motorcyclists, but you only see these shots. And that's the problem with the film, is that like it's a total Kuleshov effect, is that you have to fill in all the gaps yourself. But the problem is that when it's doing its best work, it's presenting you too many shots to try to make sense of what's going on. And I can understand, like, okay, they're on their own. They're like robbing people, but for what? Like, who are you gonna rob on a dirt road through a fucking jungle canyon for what? They need food. Who's gonna carry groceries through that? Or they don't need money. Money has no value to them in there. So like, I just didn't. I don't know. And that's part of the problem, is that like, I don't feel like it's a film for me because I just am so unknowing about whatever the fuck it is to be a child soldier. I just can't relate, you know? And or not that I can't relate. I can't even begin to understand, like, what the fuck were they stealing from those people? What do they have to gain? You know, like, why? Or why did they, at the end of the film, why did they chase off Rambo and kill a family? Like, that's one part of the film. That was the part of the film that really kind of ended it for me, which is that it's at the end of the film. But there's nobody to like in this film. They're all terrible people. And by the end of the film, you hate everybody. Everybody is garbage. But the person you probably hate the most is, I believe, Dog. He's the one who sets off the whole catalyst of bullshit events. Whereas everything's all peachy clean. You know, they're asking to be in relationships, and then they all are celebrating. You know, they make a bed for the two characters to bang in. And then the one guy gets up the next day and he's like, "Oh, let's still celebrate." And he's like shooting his gun off. And then he ends up shooting their sacred cow. And then they like have that radio. And Wolf, the leader, he's the one who got in a relationship with Lady. He's like sitting on a rock. And then there's one cool scene where the camera is like zooming in on Rambo, who is a guy, but they did his hair. I think it actually is like a female actress, but I think it's, they might be trans. I don't really know because they never took their shirt off. They look rather feminine, if you ask me. They look like they, have you ever seen Katy Perry with her short hair? That's what this character looks like. And there's a part in the beginning where Wolf wants to kiss Lady, but she's like, "Oh no, Hill, you should kiss Rambo." And he's like, "No, that'd be like kissing a brother." And she's like, "No, do it." And then he just like does it, and they're like hardcore making out. Like, it didn't look like it was by any stretch of the imagination difficult for them to do this. He seemed more comfortable kissing the guy than he did kissing his, you know, future female girlfriend, lady partner. I don't know what the fuck. They had some weird, is this in Spanish or whatever the fuck language the movie was in, so I didn't fucking get what was going on. So that's what, there was ambiguity there about, was Rambo and Wolf in a relationship? I believe so. It's kind of bizarre because like when Wolf, we are assumingly from Wolf's perspective, the camera is like zooming in on them, you know, demeeting the cow. And you think it's going into Lady, but no, the camera focuses on Rambo. And then maybe you think it's like, oh, maybe Wolf is seeing that Rambo and Lady are getting together. But no, it really just seems like Wolf's final thoughts were about Rambo, and then he kills himself. So presumably the character was homosexual, but who cares? I mean, I don't give a crap if he was gay or not. It's interesting to have that kind of different dynamic in this, you know, small cohort of children who are living on a mountaintop, secluded, but they didn't do anything with it because that character's just out of the film. And then Moses Arias, I think is his name or whatever, the Hannah Montana character, is the leader, and he's just like basically a nut job. He's a total lunatic in a lot of ways. They go to the jungle and then they like fuck up again, and the doctor leaves because they're all like swimming naked in the river, having like, you know, water games or whatever. And then he like smashes the radio and he's like, "We're our own organization." And that's a part of the film, is that there's like no context given. And I'm fine with no context for the circumstances of the rebellion or whatever, because I can fill in my head with what's going on. But I don't know, maybe it's a cultural thing. I thought the word organization was really stupid because that sounds like a corporate term or a business term. We're our own organization. Like maybe like I don't know. Just something better than organization just sounded really wrong. Maybe it's a translation thing, or maybe in their that culture, that is the term that you would use in that situation. I don't know. I just it didn't translate well to me, and that's part of the movie where it wasn't a film for me. There's no main character, there's no story. Like kids are part of a military coup rebellion thing. They fuck up. They kill their commander. They put on war paint and stalk around in the jungle. And then the two of the people run away. The doctor lady, who you almost think the movie is about the doctor because it follows her for a while. She like a little girl, one of the little girls who's like 15 years old starts making out with her, and she starts kissing her back a little bit, and it gets really awkward and weird. But she was on shrooms at the time, so whatever. I don't even know. It's a hard film to talk about because it's a hard film to watch because you can't make any sense of it. I mean, you can follow the story, but you don't really feel like you were told a story. You felt like you were listening to somebody's ramblings. And even as a, oh, the horribleness of, these rebellions and using these child soldiers or maybe having to resort to them. Doesn't it all falls flat because at the end you hate the child soldiers, but you don't hate the situation that led to the use of child soldiers, you know? At the end of the film, Rambo gets taken into this like idyllic home in the jungle. It is like so fucking jarring. And then the kids are like hunting for Rambo. Why? Why do they fucking care to hunt for Rambo? Who gives a fuck? If Rambo wants to leave your organization, it's never like none of the characters have any motivation that we can really discern other than maybe Wolf being homosexual. That's pretty much it. And Lady is probably a whore according to Rambo. I don't know. It's there's not enough under the surface to draw out the motives of the major events of the film. That's the problem. So like the people who are still part of this clique of child soldiers are like hunting for Rambo, and they find the house that he's at, and they just like kill the two parents, and then the kids are left under the thing, and then the one girl's like looking at him, and Rambo and them are in the river, and Rambo gets picked up by some like real soldiers, not these like stupid gorillas. And the doctor lady you hear on the news, like, oh, there's a big operation going there. And so, like, this film portrays the rebels as the bad guys, I believe. Because it ends the film with the kids like killing innocent civilians and just being monsters, and then they're like saving the woman. The woman is kind of is talked about in a radio news thing as being saved, kind of. And when they pick up Rambo, he's in the helicopter, and then this part of the movie was total fucking cringe, and at the end of the movie, so it really sucked. They're in the helicopter, and the guy's like, oh, so like they pick him up, they bring him in the helicopter. And they're over the city, and they're like, we're turning back to the, civilized society now. Commander, we have unidentified person on board. What do we do? And like it now, out of nowhere, he's like, Commander, what do I do? Commander, what do I do? And it's like it has this forced panic over nothing. Rambo has no weapons. Rambo is like a 15-year-old male. Presumably, who has like, and would they really execute him in the helicopter after they found him, picked him up? Like, it just seemed so stupid. It honestly seemed like a film written by somebody who has no military understanding at all. And I don't have any military understanding, but why would you ever execute somebody in a helicopter? After you went through all that effort to pick them up, at least bring them back and question them. Like, why the film tries to play it up as like, oh, is he gonna get executed right there, or is he gonna live, or whatever, And it's like, but who gives a fuck? Rambo was kind of a scumbag too for, sleeping with Lady after Wolf died, and maybe it was like a kind of weird compassionate thing that I didn't understand. I feel like a lot of the ways the movie fails are just things that maybe I just didn't understand because I'm not in the Colombian mountains as a child soldier. But at the same time, there are a lot of things that I didn't feel like I could attribute to that context to explain what I didn't understand. There was just so much random shit happening without context, and I felt fine with it in the beginning because I could understand, oh, she's a prisoner, they're using her to blackmail, they're having her record lines showing that she's okay, they're prettying her up for the videotaping and things like that. Like, I can understand what's going on, but that whole jungle sequence, just what the fuck was going on? It goes from their normal, as normal can be, to literal war paint psychopaths killing people in the jungle. And it's like a montage when they're doing that, but there's no connective tissue between the two worlds of child soldiers who are regimented to jungle warriors who are lunatics. It is just, there's nothing in between. And it, I don't know. I don't really think the film connects to Lord of the Flies at all. It's not a similar story. I have read, this is something I want to bring up. I read a review immediately after watching this film where somebody said, at least in Lord of the Flies, you got to see the descent in madness. And here, it just happens. And it's like, that's part of the terror, though, is that for these children, this madness is normal. Normalcy is only defined by, how the average of people act. It was normal to own slaves at one point. Normal is on a continuum of behavior and that changes over the course of history and changes depending on where you are geographically. I think the aspect of the movie that is best is also what hinders it the most, is that we are shown the normal life for these children as being child soldiers, but we never are horrified by it because nothing horrible ever really happens. And there are two scenes in the film where there is an incredible level of tension and stress, and the film cuts about like 3 or 5 seconds into the shot and changes and it just calms you down. The film needed to linger on a few of the incredibly stressful and anxiety and producing scenes to really make you feel uncomfortable. Because you should feel uncomfortable when you watch a movie like this with child soldiers in Colombia or wherever the fuck they are doing fucked up shit. But you don't because the film cuts too fucking fast, And they had some amazing. They didn't need to fucking cut so much. I don't. They ruined a really fucking good movie, but they didn't ruin a good story because there is no story. So, if you like South American films, if you like Spanish, I believe that's the language they were speaking because I recognize some of the words. If you are interested at all in the topic of child soldiers and want to just see things happening with good shots, but really bad camera movement shots, check it out. But there's no story. There's no main character. Everybody is unlikable. Everybody does horrible shit. But you don't feel disgusted by it. You're honestly, I was just bored. That's the worst thing that a movie can be at times is boring. So I think I give it a, in terms of my a Western approach, as a Western, film viewer used to like the hero cycle journey, that bullshit, I give it like a 3 out of 10. In more of like an objective movie approach, I would give it a 6. I think the music and the shots and some of the montage scenes in the jungle are really fucking good, but it just falls flat in its fucking face with no story, no character, but that is likable at all. And then they do completely irredeemable acts, and there's no payoff. And in fact, the movie tries to jerk you around with some kind of fake, oh, are they gonna kill Rambo? Who gives a fuck? Honestly, I don't care. I would have. There are so many better ways the movie could have ended. It's really pathetic that they chose such a kind of. the way this movie ended is akin to horror movies where the big bagoul monster jumps out of the screen and scares you at the end of the film. It is frankly fucking offensive to both my intelligence and my patience because I don't want to be fucking waiting for your stupid scare that I know is coming and then jumps on the fucking screen with full Dolby Digital Giga surround sound, extra 45 speakers in my ears, blowing my eardrums out just for you to give me a little quick startle. Like, fuck off with that shit. Just fuck off. Yeah. So, I guess somewhere in between, it's like a 5 out of 10. Whatever.